IPL suspended, NBA suspended, Premier League postponed due to the coronavirus outbreak. So now there's that one big event later this summer that everyone is worried about, the Tokyo Olympics. Will it happen? Why can't it be postponed? Can it be cancelled altogether? Who's set to lose the most if it is cancelled? Who makes the final call? By when will we have a final call? Well, here I am trying to answer some of those questions in this week's Spotlight. Are the Olympics on? Yes, the opening ceremony slotted for 24th July, and the International Olympic Committee President Thomas Bach and even Japanese Prime Minister Shinzo Abe have denied even entertaining any thought of cancellation.
Today in the meeting of the executive board, neither the word cancellation nor the word postponement was even mentioned.
That was on the 5th of March. Since then though, countries have shut borders, athletes have tested positive for coronavirus, and all qualification tournaments have been cancelled. The new line followed by Bach as of 13th March is that the IOC will be following the WHO's recommendation, the world body that has declared the coronavirus a pandemic. If postponing an option seems easy enough though, right? Well, that's what Donald Trump thought as well when he said, maybe, and this is just my idea, maybe they postpone it by a year. Now, are you and Donald Trump thinking the same thoughts? Well, that's your personal problem. But well, Tokyo organizers are having none of it. The IOC and the organizing committee are not considering cancellation or a postponement. Absolutely not at all, was Japan's Olympic minister's reply to Trump's comment. And the reason that postponing, in fact, may not even be an option open to the Games organizers is that the two-week window of the event has been decided years back, with tournaments and leagues around the world working around it. There is also, and the most important factor, of the broadcaster to consider. US network NBC has paid $1 billion for the rights to the Tokyo Olympics, where the NBA, NFL, Grand Slams and golf and many other events lined up for later in the year. Finding another two-week window may not be an easy one. Now, if you were to postpone it by a year or two, it could also clash with the upcoming Winter Olympics or the Football World Cup in 2022. So are we looking at a cancellation now? If things don't improve, then yes. Because unlike the Premier League or the IPL, that can close doors to fans, the Olympics will see over 11,000 athletes and more support staff coming together in the Games Village itself. So do you choose to then put so many people at risk, or do you refuse participation to, say, in Italy or Spain or China, countries that are reporting the maximum casualties so far? The Olympics have been cancelled before three times, in fact, during World War I and World War II. However, a cancellation this time will have massive financial consequences. So how much money is at stake? A lot. According to a national government audit, Tokyo is spending $28 billion on these Olympic Games, all of which will see no returns if the event is cancelled. There is also nearly $1 billion in ticket sales that will be lost. Television broadcast rights and sponsorship deals comprise 91% of the IOC's income. In the Rio Olympic cycle, the IOC had an income of $5.7 billion, all of which will be lost if the Games are cancelled this time around. However, all involved parties are insured. The IOC paid $14 million to insure the Rio Olympics, so they can be expected to collect a big return this time round. Japan, though, will suffer the biggest loss. While they may be insured against the loss of ticket sales and maybe some sponsorship, a massive chunk of their spending have been on stadiums and infrastructure, returns of which they would have expected to get in the form of tourism, which now may not happen. A final decision. So, well, with so much at stake, it may be understandable that the IOC is not jumping the gun or announcing any decision about the Games until they just finally must. If the opening ceremony is to take place on the 24th of July, then by early June latest, a call should be made if the wheels need to get in motion. The 11,000 athletes need to prepare for the Games, make arrangements for travel. The village needs to be ready. Broadcasters need to set up equipment. So, well, who makes the final call? Yes, the last one. Like one Japanese minister suggested, can the Games be held anytime in 2020? Because that's what their contract says, right? Not really, because any date change or cancellation is completely out of Japan's hands now. The host city contract signed by the IOC and the city of Tokyo and the Japanese Olympic Committee gives all decision-making powers to the IOC. Under the heading Termination, Clause 66 of the official Tokyo 2020 host city contract, the IOC has the right to terminate a game because of a state of war, civil disorder, boycott, or if the IOC has reasonable grounds to believe in its sole discretion that the safety of participants in the game would be seriously threatened or jeopardized for any reason whatsoever, like a deadly virus that is now claiming thousands of lives. So while it seems like there's still a while to go before a final decision on the Tokyo Olympics need to be made, why don't you tell us in the comment section below what you think should be the fate of the game.